Okay, in a separate video, I talked about how I thought it was pretty cool that you could look at a conditionally convergent series, and you could actually rearrange the terms to get different values. And we're actually going to prove in a different video that you can take a conditionally convergent series, and you can actually rearrange the values in a way so that you can get any real number that you want, which again kind of blows my mind. But here I just want to look at a quick example just to hopefully convince you that it can in fact be done. So I'm going to look at the alternating harmonic series, which is 1 minus a half plus a third minus a fourth plus a fifth minus a sixth. I'm going to do two more terms, plus a seventh minus an eighth plus dot dot dot. You can actually prove that that equals the natural logarithm of 2. And if you're interested in seeing this proof, let me know, and I'll justify it. So, okay, but if you take it at face value that this alternating harmonic series does converge to the natural logarithm of 2. So again, it's conditionally convergent because this series does converge to a finite number. If we look at the absolute value of this series, though, we'll get all positive terms, and that's just going to turn into the harmonic series, which does in fact diverge. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to multiply. I'm going to multiply both sides just by 1/2. Okay, so if we multiply both sides by 1/2, well, 1 multiplied by 1/2 will give us a half. Then we'll have minus a fourth plus 1/6 minus 1/8 plus dot dot dot. I'm not going to write them all down. And, well, if we multiply both sides by 1/2, on the right side we'll be left with 1/2 multiplied by the natural logarithm of 2. Okay, so nothing too crazy yet. Now, what I'm going to do to the series that we just produced, I'm actually going to insert some zeros. Okay, so the way I'm going to do this is I'm going to start off, I'm going to insert a zero at the beginning, then I'm going to have plus 1/2. And the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to insert another zero, and then I'm going to have minus 1/4. I'm just going to insert zeros in between each term. So plus 0, then we'll have plus 1/6. Plus 0, we would have minus 1/8. Plus dot dot dot. So all I'm doing is throwing in some zeros, so that's not going to change its value. So we've still got 1/2 multiplied by the natural logarithm of 2. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add my original series, this alternating harmonic series, with this new series, and let's see what in fact what happens when we add those two together. Well, when we add them together, right, we would have 1 plus 0, which would be 1. The negative 1/2 and the positive 1/2 would cancel. 1/3 plus 0 would be positive 1/3. We would have negative 1/4 plus a negative 1/4, which is going to give us a negative 1/2. We've got, let's see, 1/5 plus 0, which is going to give us positive 1/5. We've got negative 1/6 plus positive 1/6, which is going to cancel. We'll have 1/7 plus 0, which is going to be positive 1/7. The negative 1/8s are going to cancel out. You could actually if you expend a little bit more, the next term is actually going to be negative 1/4. And you can just keep, checking the values that I'm getting here. So dot, 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 that's going to keep going. But now we've got the natural logarithm of 2 plus 1/2 the natural logarithm of 2, right? We've added these series on the left, so we're going to add these values on the right. That's going to give us 3/2 multiplied by the natural logarithm of 2. But let's just compare now this new series that I produced. Let's compare that with the original series, and notice that it's actually the same values, it's the same terms being used, but they're in a different order, right? I still have my positive 1, there's my positive 1/3, there's my negative 1/2, there's my positive 1/5, and my positive 1/7, there's my negative 1/4, and that would be the pattern in this new series. You're going to have two positive terms, then a negative term, two positive terms, then a negative term, two positive terms, then a negative term. So again, we're using the exact same numbers, just in a different order, and lo and behold, we actually get a totally different value. So I think this is cool. I think it's interesting. So again, it just goes to show how when you deal with infinite, when you deal with infinity, you've got to be really careful. Again, your intuition doesn't hold anymore a lot of times. Totally different things will happen. So anyways, I hope you think this is interesting. I'm going to actually prove, again, what I said at the beginning, that you can take a conditionally convergent series and make it, you know, you can rearrange the terms in such a way so that you can produce any real number that you want, which again I think is really amazing. So that's going to be definitely pretty technical and long, but if you're interested, please come check it out. I'll have it up soon.